Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon for your Commodore Amiga personal computer. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome to the 50th episode. This is going to be a special double or triple long episode, 1 hour plus, something like that, is what I normally do for all the 50th level episodes. 50th level? 50th episode. So we've got the old crypt, otherwise known as the Crypt of the Magicians. We've explored quite a bit of, found some goodies, fought a lot of skeletons, zombies, ghouls, and then banshees, which are very deadly to the party, the latter. And now we've got this room, which doesn't look like it goes anywhere, but we've got a button here, and we've got a button here. So they must reveal doors, or a door. Probably a door on either side, so we'll press the button and see what happens. Bloop. Check the map. Oh! We've got a force field here. Teleporter. Not force field. I meant teleporter. And then there's another button on the other side. Does that reveal another teleporter? I was sure it was going to reveal some doors in this map. Teleport on either side. Interesting, I thought it was going to reveal a door here to, like, move upwards. Well, where did they go and which one should we push? I mean, go through. Very interesting indeed. Hello. Where do you take us? So we're here really looking for this ring for well, not Nelvin came with us. He wants to go to the Black Wizard's Tower, which I hope is not as quite of a slog as it was in Amberstar. But where did I write this? What's the guy's name? Alkem. Alkem in the Tower of the Alchemists. He's looking for artifacts, specifically a magical ring, so that his shop will open up and he can make, I guess, potions. Yeah, he calls them drinks, actually, so yeah. Alright, so where does this one take us? And couldn't we ever get back? Poof. Okay, new area. Hopefully we can get back out of here at some point. The monster eye is not lit up yet. There's no field behind us. So let's strafe over. Nope. So if we come across more of those banshees, I'm just using the holy horn and being done with them. Hello. Ghouls. Okay, we can deal with ghouls. Ghouls are doable. Mudsling spell. I will wait for the other one. Might as well defend then. Bonk. Let's focus on this one then. Since we can. And Nice. Two in a row. Successful. Nice going, Nelvin. No, we couldn't get three in a row with that. Maybe we can get another one off before it runs out of spell points. Bonk, yes. Doesn't do a lot of damage, but I love the animation. I'm actually gonna switch him to the other one. Selena's out of ammunition. Bonk. But we can have her start using the magical arrows. I think one of us has some more arrows, or did we already hand them over to her? I guess we already gave them to her. So this is all she has in the world, is 58 magical arrows. Been trying to be a little conservative with these, but we do have more at home. And we also have more, I think. We have a spell points 4 and 5, which I'm not going to use. Unless I really need to. So let's use one spell point 3. She missed a target. I think she was aiming at the last one. Okay, so he's got, yeah, half spell points now. So I can throw some more mudslings. Bonk. That was a nice hit. One more mudsling. Failed. Wah wah. He's sitting out the fight because I don't want to use more of those. Spell points potions. Her attack is just completely failing now. I guess that's normal. I wonder if we can go back to the alchemist, if he will buy just anything from us. That'll be helpful. Well, we might be stuck here. I hope not. But if not, we can just load up episode 49. Then all we have to do is press the buttons again and go through the other field, I guess. Hopefully we're not stuck here. That would be lame. Let's take a look where we are. We've been around here and we're heading up north at this point. Oh, more of these windows. I've been looking at the windows and just never any description or anything about them. Twisty turny passages here. Another button. Let's head to the end. I guess I'm mapping out the room. Have you been everywhere except here? Oh, there's another field here. Teleport field here. But I want to see what the button does before we go through. And we still got this teleport field to go through. Click. The door wasn't there before. Alright, let's go through the teleport field. Should probably bring us back to that room, I'm thinking. Oh! Right in the spinner! Thanks, teleport field. Stand by, guys. Okay, where was I? Oh. Getting spun around. That's where I was. Right, I was gonna go through the other teleporter first. Before going through this door. Problem is, I think I'm headed for the one I already went through. Not sure. Let's see where I end up. Yeah. This one I haven't gone through. Boing. I thought I saw a door or something. I like strafing over so I can see what's coming. Boop. Oh. Here we come. Hi! Let me position myself just right for your arrival. A ghoul and a ghoul. Ghouly ghouly ghoul. Oh, I forgot to rest and get his spell points back. Now he is utterly useless to us. And she's using the magical arrows. don't seem to be having much luck with them. But you can use them. Attack plus 10. So, that's reflected here. 45, yeah. Her attack was... had to be 35. I know it was less than 45. Whenever I get her thieving abilities maxed out, which is probably be for... take quite a while to do, I'll improve her attack. And I will defend and wait for the arrival of the other ghoul. Ought to split up in such a way that... alright. Doing some damage on us. Banged up here. Have to heal some people soon. Ow. Okay. Well, they're attacking. Healing potion 4. 2. Throwing it to Celine, which seems like a weird thing. But she's gonna use a potion on one of us so we can keep attacking. Potion 4. 2. I've got to be at less points than him. 39 and 50, yeah, so... that did well. So now for Agile. Oof. End is near, sir. Extremely nigh. Surprised by how much we can carry, actually. Well, we're at our limit now. Onward. another button. I wonder if it reveals another door to the north. There's more this way. Or is there? Oh, yeah, another teleport field. Okay. We will press the button and go through the teleporter. Not close enough. What did that reveal? I still only see one door here. Maybe it opened another door inside this room that we can't see because we've not gotten there yet. B. To the teleporter. I'm trying to exit out. Wait, oh, you can do that. Poof! Onto the spinner again. So we're probably facing here. So I want to turn around. It's going to spin us back. Or will it? Which way am I? Nah. Even when you don't move, it spins you. Yeah, that's the way I want to go. If it lets me step forward. Is this one of the doors? Yeah. And that door was not here before. Another door, which that might have been revealed by the button pressing. Don't know. Otherwise, we might just have this blank room or empty room. Couldn't say, because I pressed it before I even came in here. Sorry I keep saving, but I have a feeling we're coming up to some ultimate battle here. Alright, so we've got another coffin. Oh. A small ring is visible in the thick dust. Alkem's ring. Is it a magic item? Doesn't say it is. We can't even carry a ring. Selena is just bending down to lift the ring when you suddenly hear a loud banging from a coffin near the entrance. Then its lid bursts into a thousand pieces, a horribly ugly undead in fine but very ancient robes bearing magical symbols climbs out of the coffin and stands in the entrance to the crypt. He seems to examine you carefully with his empty eye sockets. Apparently satisfied, he scratches his bald skull and drones in an unnaturally deep and reverberant voice. You mortal midgets dare to disturb my peace? For that, I will make you into my undead servants, just like the others. Hi. Who are you? Lich Lord? Oh my god. Okay. Oh, I never got his magic back. Well, I don't think we'd even work on him. Holy Horn. Oh, I'm gonna move it. I don't imagine it would work on him. But I'll use it on this Banshee. Maybe I'll have him take a potion after all. Oh, damage. Ow. Thunderbolts? Ow. I wish we had our spell up, but I can't. I mean, our magical shield. I can't really spare the time to do that because I need to start healing. Unless I have Selena heal me. That's only a healing potion too, though. I don't want to use them up like crazy either. If we die, then we're loading. Healing potion 3. I'm not using healing potion 4 and 5, no way. Healing potion 3. On himself. Three. And I have them. I might as well use them. And then I will attempt to get this magical shield out. Doing sickle. Fail. Who's he attacking? Nelvin? I missed who he was attacking. I have a feeling that the Holy Horn won't work on him, otherwise I'd try it. I could use it to get rid of the ghouls. Quickly, anyway. But first, I want to get the shield up and not be almost dead. So, magical shield. Windhowler spell. Oh god. Spell failed again. The rest of us are doing okay right now. Well, we did successfully pick the ring up. I thought he interrupted us before we were able to actually even do that. Potion 4. I don't want to use Healing Potion 4. That's all we have left. We have a 3 here. Nelvin. Oops. I'm surprised she can carry so much, yeah. Well, that's Nelvin carrying that much. He's pretty strong for a mage. Okay, so he... It's not even gonna help, but... Throwing mud at the lich. Healing potion 3 is our last healing potion 3. And citrine. We'll just attack that. Citrine will try to get this magic shield up again. Okay. Got it up, okay. So now. I don't know. Do we want to even do that? Because I might want whatever goodies he has. Maybe I'll just use the Holy Horn on the Banshees. Bonk. He deflected it. Yeah, 8 points of damage. Whoosh. One more mudsling. If I only had one of these, I'd be a lot more sparing of them, but... I have 2 more. We have 15 charges each, so it's pretty good. Bonk. 12 points. I need more healing. Advancing. Advancing. He's out of mana. Magical projectile does 2 points of damage, not really worth it. I just have him defend, I guess? I don't want to use up all these spell point potions. But, yeah. I don't want her to die. So we've got 4. Healing potion 4. Got some 4 here. Use the spell points. Oh. You try to use it on him. No, I don't want to use it. I don't want to use it on him. I want whatever goodies he has. He probably has something really good. If you destroy them, I don't think you get their inventory, their items at all, so. Attack? Oh. Selena will instead use one of these potions on me. Oh, nice. So we... Just checking. We've all got our armor and stuff. I'm gonna see. I'm only doing this in case one of our weapons or our armor breaks. I'm gonna do save state. Try to defeat him with conventional means. Now that it's just him anyway. Looks like he might be out of mana. Just using a throwing sickle. I want that throwing sickle, actually. Lich Lord, wow. I hope he doesn't break his throwing sickle, because I want it. Yay! 267 experience. Selena, level 5. She's leveling up quickly now. 17 training points, nice. 35 total life points or hit points, whatever. Nelvin, level 5. He's got a bunch of points to use. 27 hit points now. So I've got a mage's robe, which might be better than just a regular robe. I think we have a mage's robe somewhere. Check that. A lich crown. It's a helmet. I don't want to put it on. I want to get this identified just in case it's cursed. You never know. We might put it on and turn one of us into an undead fiend or something. Plus 8 shield, though. That's pretty good, because Edgel's is plus 4. And anyone can use this. I mean, well, not everyone, but a lot of classes. So Train can use it. Definitely taking in any case. And a throwing sickle. I think we have one of those. No gold. So I got the ring. Maybe we're going to return to Alkem the Alchemist. I wonder if we can sell some of these things there. We have another throwing sickle and a little secret home in our house. Damage plus 10. Healer, alchemist, mystic, and mage. Oh! So, Nelvin can use that. Nice. That's what I identify at first, make sure it's not cursed or anything. Yeah, the other throwing sickle must be at the house. Okay. That was quite a battle. We're gonna save. So we've got another casket to open and fight things inside, I guess. Mapping out the room, looks like to be the final area here. So he might have burst out of here instead. I just saved though. Let's just see. Nothing happens. Well, he burst out of there already. And so there's nothing else to discover then. Just make sure. And nothing. Okay. Alright, let's get the hell out of here then. Just double check the map, make sure nothing else has been revealed. So that's it for the Crypt of the Magicians. You'll notice it says Old Crypt on the map. The sign outside says in the ancient script, Crypt of the Magicians. Turn us around. It would normally turn us toward the door. Yeah, I'm near it. Just make sure. Yeah. Straight through, pretty much. Oh, you're turning us around. Spinning us. Well, this is the room with the teleport field, so we can't take that way around. I didn't even move yet. Oh, you're so annoying. Where am I now? Looks like I'm by the door that I want to go through. I'm gonna save here because I think I've headed the wrong way at one point. We gotta go around. Oh. Like this. Okay. And it should be right out. And it'll head back to Alkem. So funny. I didn't even realize at first that his name was Alkem the Alchemist. Now we're really close by, so hopefully we can just... Of course. Alright, never mind. Use a torch or rest. Let's rest. I think he still has all the rations, yeah. She doesn't even actually need one. Damn you. Let us rest. Just to go over here. closer than I remember, actually. This is his alchemist tower. You figure he'd put lights in here. I wonder if he'll give us the keys of finally to get through these two other doors. The doors are barred. Alright, but that's the way up there. Get out of my way, pillar. I think he's in this side. It's his bedroom. I think that's the guest room where we found Nelvin. I think. Who puts these pillars right in front of a door like that? Really poor design. I don't mean game design. I'm not ripping on the developer. Just in-game design. Is this the way we're supposed to go? I think so. Yeah, I see. A tunnel here. A hallway, rather. Is that you? A little save here. Make myself the leader because he doesn't speak self. Hi. Got something for you. I think I actually should give it to him. Yeah. I think Celine has it. Oh, come on. I hate to have empty spaces in the middle, that's why I keep rearranging things, guys. We need more arrows for her soon. Preferably magical ones. We might be able to buy them in the Rogues or Thieves Guild. Here you go. Many, many thanks. At last I can continue my work. Let me give you something special and thanks. He raises his stick and swings it above your head, whereupon glistening dust rains down on you. You have a strange feeling that you are suddenly able to learn new skills. Really? They give me training points or something? I'm wondering what changed. He's still saying that. I found your ring. 6 a.m. So what did you give to me? Farewell, and do not forget, my library and the shop are open from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Well, you're open then. Don't leave, you're open. Sounds being bashful now. Hello, you young heroes. It is nice to see you. Thank you again for returning my ring to me. I now feel complete again. I think you have issues. I like the way his look, though, and I like the tattoos or markings on his forehead. Pretty cool looking. And of course, those white eyes make him extra mysterious. The shop. Is this the shop, or am I supposed to go somewhere else? Maybe it's back where we were. Maybe those areas are now open. Because I remember there being a library. Maybe that's what I do, I just go back down below. If that's true, then we don't have to go up to the second floor anymore. I can't go past that way. So we're not skinny enough. Alright, so oh, maybe it's these two doors. Maybe now they will. Now that's still no longer be barred. One's a library, one's a shop. I think I understand now. Alchemistic library. So now we'll be able to go in. Now we'll be able to go in here. Nice. You want to extend your knowledge of magical spells. Alright. Probably not getting any yet, because I have a bunch at home. I don't remember which ones. There are light, magical torch, magical lantern, ghost weapon, create food. So these are usable by me. Adventurer, thief, or alchemist. Like all of them. Remove curses. Yeah, it's gonna be that way for all of them. Alright. I'm just gonna look at them. Light, magical torch, magical lantern, ghost weapon, create food, remove curses, jump, magical shield, magical wall, magical weapon, magical assault, levitation, 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 levitation. Anti-magic wall, Uri, and LP Stealer. Yeah, I'll run back home and see which ones. I'll memorize whatever I can and see which ones we can which ones left that we haven't and we'll buy them up. Okay. Well, good to know. So, and this is the potions. Alchemistic accessories. Catchy name. Incredible bargains, yeah. Whoa, look at that healing potion. 1, 2, 3, 4. All healing potion, nice. Revitalizing flask. Cure poison flask. We got empty flasks. Spell points 1, 2, 3, and 4. What else? Ooh. Spell points 5. We got strength potion, intelligence, dexterity, speed, constitution, charisma, anti-magic, and 3 bitters. Wow. I want to buy much. Much stuff. I gotta come back here with a lot of gold. So I think we want to buy an empty flask here for this antidote for the fisherman's daughter, the poor girl. Get empty phial, he says. Well, flask, I'm thinking, would be the same thing, hopefully. So I need at least one. He buy things? He only has a few slots. I don't want to mess things up, so let's just save. I don't know if the chainmail will stack. I don't want to get to the point where he won't buy anything from us. $423 gold. I think it's stacking. Yeah. And once these slots are used up, these two slots, that's it. I'll have to, like, buy something else off of him to free his slot, because he'll be full. Funny how it works like that. He won't run out of money, like you see in some games like Skyrim, but he'll run out of space for his own inventory. Alright, so stuff first, right? Oh, I should be passing this stuff to me, actually, because I have the best charisma. If I really want to make some good money here. Guessing the flails are stacking as well, I hope. Definitely saving this sickle. of one. I'm just gonna peek, make sure it's stacking for him, yeah. Never sure what items will stack and which won't. So item into gold. So the flails are 127, not that much at all. No. I just wanted to move that. What did I do? Do I still have it? Yeah. Does she have anything else? I just want to sell all the chainmail and flails first. Before I take up his last slot. Making money here. How many will it stack? That's another question. Unlimited? Or like 20 or something. Look at all this money we got, 9,000. And we got like a lot more honey money at home. Money, honey. So, flail. Flail. So, another flail. There's another chainmail. And then I can start selling the padded leather. And, well, that's regular leather. Oh, and then ironclad leather, so those are not going to stack together. Sell the padded leather and the chainmail and flails. Gotta be strategic about this. Before I do anything, please. Okay, padded leather, 147. What happened? He's full. Let's buy a speed potion. Actually, what's Nelvin's intelligence at? Mm-hmm. He can go up a little bit more. What about me? I could go up more. Yeah. That would probably help me, so... I will buy... intelligence potion. I will also buy a speed potion. Then I can sell more things. I'm guessing the padded leather is stacking them. Yes. So I can sell regular leather. So a short bow. Okay, so now he's full again. Take a strength potion. I'll buy all these things out. Dexterity. Constitution. Anti-magic potion. Oh, does that increase our resist magic? We've got charisma. Okay, so now we can sell more things. But none of these things. Sell these leathers and the short bow. Short sword. The Lich Crown. Gotta figure out what that does. Exciting. And the short sword. And another short bow. Another short bow. Okay, good. We'll sell the rest of the lot. Okay. I think we're done selling things. Now, who had the speed potion? One of us had one. Did I use it? I thought we were just carrying around with us. My intelligence could stand me better. So I'm going to just take this potion now. My intelligence is 30. Now 33. If I had a speed, maybe I put it, maybe I left it at the house after all. I wanted to save it for our healer so they can get off heals quicker whenever we get one. And I bought a speed potion. I thought I already had one. I was gonna stack it with the one we already had, but... Hold on. Alright, so do I now want to buy some healing potions? Yes, I do. Potion 3. 2500. Agree. What else? All healing potion? Getting low on stuff. So we need a flask. I'm gonna buy two just in case. I gotta go to the swamp soon. I might head back home first so I can get Nelvin properly, you know, set up. So we've got healing potion 2, a bunch of those. All the stuff we sell, anti-magic, bitters, points, poison, yeah, I think we'll leave it like this. Pretty awesome, okay. I hate to run back all the way home, but... into a dead end room. Well, that was successful. Mm. Maybe we should head back to the house in Burnville. Find some stuff for Nelvin and identify some things. See if we can buy Selena some arrows, if I remember that. Put that rock there. Right in our way. How inconvenient. Surprised I found my way here so easily. Not so long after all, is it? Seemed like it going there, but... I don't know what's where. We have spell points here. I'll just give that to him. More spell points. More spell points. Okay, so these black ones can be used by mage. Magical projectile. Well, he already knows that, so I'm gonna sell that. He knows mudsling, so I'm gonna sell that. He knows sleep as well. Thief mage. Should I keep this, maybe give it to her as a just in case kind of spell? Necromancer dagger. Usable by mage. Damage plus 7. He can use an LP stealer. Oh, and it helps him with reading magic, definitely. That's right, I remember looking at this and saying, if nothing else, we can just equip this on him for when he wants to memorize some magic spells. Yeah. Absolutely. Thief, Ranger, Mystic. Blue ones, Adventure, Thief, Alchemist. So, I can know this spell. This is like a haste. Only for some reason called Hurry. I'm gonna try to learn that one. This is your healer then. Paladin, Thief, and Healer. And this is what again? Mystic? Thief, Ranger, and Mystic. Healer. Adventure. And Blink. Might as well try to learn these spells. And this is... a wind devil. Maybe I'll have her hold on to this just in case, because he knows the spell. Just in case we're in trouble. And we have gold. I don't know if we really need to buy that many more potions. We could use it to buy more spell points, you know. More healing potions, but do we really need to? We have a bunch now. So it might be good for now. Do we need rations, actually? We have 13 total rations. Oh no. Wrong thing. we should get some rations. Enough for now. We don't want it to weigh us down. Alright, screw it. Take 10 more. Alright, what else we got? More spell points. A sling we don't need, he has one. Sling stones? Why not? Magical arrows for mage and fear. He doesn't know those. And then we've got earth slide. I think he knows that one. And lame. And then light. And sell the rest. Magical torch. Just for adventure, yeah. Magical projectile to sell. Got a lot of those. Remove panic is for a healer. Here's our other holy horn. Another 15 charges. We have two with us already. Chainmail shirt. Look great, we're able to store things in chests. Magical shield. I have already. I could sell it. Ironclad leather shoes. I don't know if he can wear boots. Flint and iron. Huh. Okay, that's just a regular robe. I think we could sell that then. Blind spell? That's for mage. Wow, we're gonna be busy here. How many ironclad leathers do we need? I think I threw them here because I didn't want to sell them anywhere. Yeah, I didn't want to run back down to the Thieves Guild, but now I am going to run back to Thieves Guild, see if we can get her some magical arrows. Selena. That's a Netzrak staff. I think this is a compass. Magical compass. Do we have some of these with us? Heal lameness? Vitalizing. Maybe we should take a couple, just in case. What's revitalizing? Lameness. Anything else? So you have some special kind of robes. Probably mage robes, just like what I have. Okay. Magical weapon. This is for adventure. Try to memorize it. Rockfall. Small healing poison. Might as well. Find traps, really? Oh wait, Thief, Ranger, Mystic. Alright, we don't have anyone who can use that. Just wanna make sure no one picked up the green skull. Thought you might have. Alright. So, what else? Which chest was I looking in? Knowledge? Thief Ranger. I wonder what that does. Alright, we were looking in that one, so I'm assuming we already looked in this one? Yeah. And I think this one is empty. Which leaves this one. A mage's robe. Shield plus 10. Other shoes. Throwing sickle. So now we have two of them. His robe is plus 4. This is plus 10. Wow. Nice. Okay. Getting late. Rest yet? Unfortunately, it's in the middle of the night. I could rest and then it'll be almost night again. Town to sell some stuff. Identify some stuff. I hate crossing that bridge. Hi. Now, in order to sell things, I have to go down to the Thieves Guild. Unfortunately, we have to wait around. Because they don't open until 1 in the morning. By the time we get over there, yeah, it's going to be open. This way I don't waste a torch waiting down here. It took us 45 minutes and then 5 while we were standing here. Just to walk over here. We Incredible bargains, yes. Oh, he's got a speed potion too. Oh no, this is selling. That's our inventory. Maybe we should just buy a compass. I mean, we have a broken one. But then we'd have to run back and get our money. There's a lot of healing in this. Revitalizing flask. Wow, he's not selling arrows. So he's got four slots. We'll take all these. Take all these magical projectiles then. Sixty gold pieces, 10 each. All right. Mudsling. That's all I wanted to sell. He's got one slot left. And I think we're gonna sell one thing. And what happened to our other speed potion? Did I use it? I don't remember using it. We'll sell one of the ironclad leathers. I don't think I can sell two to him. Maybe. Well, I can. Okay. He's got one slot open. So that's all I wanted to sell. And then a robe or two. so I'm probably gonna have him use the dagger. No, he won't tick anymore. And unfortunately, there's nothing from him we'd want to buy. Alright, well, there's not much more we want to sell, so we're pretty good. The only other thing I want to do is identify some things, and then I guess off-screen I'll memorize these spells, because it's just going to be a pain. You're just going to see me reload over and over again. I'll just report back at the beginning of next episode and tell you which ones I memorized. Which ones... Hopefully I can memorize all of them. It depends on the spell learning points if I have enough to do so. But first... Man, I'm kind of getting tired. Have to go in here in the middle of the night. We'll go identify some things. First, we'll rest at the healers. What does this guy want? Trainers. Oh, you could probably train him too. Agile, right? Is there some training points? No, he didn't level up. He did not level up. Oh, Selena. When can we... When is the trainers open, actually? Is there a torch still in effect? Nope. You want to train her up. Train her up. I'm not even going to bother looking at the signs. See what the fuck it is. Finding traps, yes. Let me look at her. Let me take a look at you. Okay. So find traps is 50. Picking locks is 33, but then again, we have the lock picks with us. I think for now I want to get her find traps and disarm traps up a little more, and we'll work on the lock picking soon. Yeah. So she's 17 training. Let's put 8 in there. Giving her fine traps 58%. Disarming. Put the rest into disarming. Okay, she's trained up. Just like that. Alright, so find traps 58%, disarm traps 57%. Someone will put into lockpicking, don't worry. Alright. Now, I would like to level up in magic and Nelvin too, but we don't have a place to do that. Maybe in Burnville. Hoping. And Edgel doesn't need to be trained up. He didn't level up yet. Okay, now, let's go to the healers. And rest there, because it's a lot cheaper. And it's near the sage, anyway. There's the sage, healers is here. Well, it's 6 in the morning. Been up all night dealing with these rogues, these roguish types. What brings you meteor in? Sleeping. Only 20 gold pieces? You know, I wonder something actually. Still 20. Alright, we gotta get to the sage before they close. Or he closes. They're flapping their arms around. Maybe they think that they're birds. Yes! Mysterious artifacts. Which holy horn is not... I don't want to waste money looking at the wrong one. This one is known. It is known. This one is not. So take the known one. Give it to Agile. Spells. Give me a pain. Okay, so the one she has. I know, I'm just double making double sure. Okay. The holy horn she has is not identified. So we'll identify it, see how many charges there are on it, and all that fun stuff. 14 charges of spell undead. Interesting. I didn't use it once. At least I don't think I did. Okay. And what else? Do we try to identify that? I probably did try. This is a magical item. Let me save. Because he's probably gonna charge me anyway. Whether he can tell me anything or not. Unknown. But you know what? It might be worth it because I didn't have the iron butt next to it before, but now I do. So, in case I look at it later, I won't be like, whoa, I didn't identify this. So, I'm gonna keep it as is. Alright, what else? What if you identify, like, one of these things? About the mage's robe. Anti-magic plus 5 using magic. Plus 5. That's different. Oh wait, is it? Hold on. Regular robe. But... Plus 10. Anti-magic plus 5, using magic plus 15. What about his? It's the same? Oh, we don't know. identify his. Oh, it's the same. Anti-magic, using magic. Okay. I guess I didn't even realize it was something we could identify. Oh, LP max plus 10. Okay, cool. I didn't notice that. Is the other one like that too? Could be worth it. Well, it is. Yeah, they're identical. I can tell anyway. So this is plus 10. Really? It's more than the chainmail? So what am I doing wearing the chainmail for? Shield plus 8? Plus 10. Oh, because I can't wear it. I'm an adventurer. Wah, wah. How lame. I guess I am wearing the chainmail after all. Alright. Alright, what else? Oh, we don't seem to have enough money. I'm out of money. Are you kidding me? Wait, no. I'm exiting. I didn't realize that would happen. Ran out of money. Who's this person? Oh, it's the person in this shop. It's now closed. Oh, no, you're still here. So this stuff is mystic. It's all mystic. Right. I gotta go back and get more money. Can we leave this crap? What else do I have to identify? Oh, of course, the Lich Crown. Back to myself. Link potion. A throwing sickle, just in case it is magical? Not too much. I hate the amount of money. I can't just, like... Ugh. I don't think I'd use up that many. That much. Well, night is falling anyway. Alright, go grab the money, get some rest, head back. Good thing we have this trove of money here. Over 15,000 gold. How much did I get? 1,000. 1,000 can only identify 4 things. Let me just take 2,000 with me just in case. Because I want to see if I can buy some arrows too, maybe from the shopkeep? I don't know if anyone can even take this much. Yeah, I can take it. Take it all! Straight to the bank. Secret room. sheepy time. Oh god. It's late. I don't know how long we have to wait. There we go. Alright, back to town. Opens at 10, I think. Yeah, so you gotta wait an hour. I'm just gonna save because I want to know what these stat ability potions say anything when you identify them like that. Speed potion. Increase speed 01. Base charisma 01. Yeah, that's what you'd think. Increase stamina. It's funny, it's called the Constitution potion, but it increases stamina. Not gonna keep that. So I don't need to identify anything else, but speed potion. Oh, I have the other speed potion. And he has a speed potion, but I didn't see that. I kept thinking, like, I lost one or I left it somewhere else. So if I give it to him, it's gonna stack? Yeah. I don't know what my problem was with that. I couldn't see that he had it. I don't know. What else do we want to identify? Anything else for him? I don't think so. Oh, the Lich Crown. Don't be surprised if it's a cursed item. Plus 8. Oh, look at that. Anti-magic plus 5, reading magic plus 50. I get 5 charges of magical arrows. Oh, those were those arrows he was throwing at us, right? They weren't doing much damage to us. Spell points max 25. That's awesome! And it's a shield plus 8. What am I wearing now? Sun helmet. Shield plus 3. Magical sun. Glad I even had that on. So who can use this? A lot of people. Maybe I'll hand this down to Nelvin, and I'll take the Lich Crown. Adventurer. Mage can wear that. And then... yeah, I can wear that. Right. because I really stink at using and reading magic. So, because he has a necromancer dagger. So now his read magic is 62. You're dismissed for now. I just want to see something. Wow, that's much better. This will help us learn these spells. Okay, so you have the necromancer dagger. And then my read magic is 23. It is read magic that this helps with, right? Not use. That'd be even better if it was use magic. Yeah, reading magic. Plus 50. What did I say it was again? 23. So it should now be 73. My defense goes up. Nice. We're gonna read some magic. Hell yeah. And then this group places Dinky Little Hat. Shield plus one. Alright, good. Anything else you have to, identify? The sickle, just to see if it's magical. The whip, maybe? His Gala's staff, which is a second one. And that's a... Attack plus 10. Okay. The whip. Nothing. But good to know. And then something he has. The other Gala staff. Oh, the sphere of opening I want to see as well. So 5 charges of mass healing, just like the other one. And then sphere of opening. Nothing. Alright. Thank you very much. I didn't mean to hit that, but that's where I want to go. Alright, to the merchant, see if we can buy some arrows. Nelvin can use leather boots. I can't sell him anything, right? Because I would give him one of these robes. I would sell him one of these robes. Ugh. I'll buy a knife from you. So I can sell you the robe and the hat. And you can stack it with your other stuff. How about that? She sold arrows. Not sure where I can buy arrows then. Trying to look at his inventory. See if he has a dagger. He does. So I should be able to sell him a dagger and the hat. That's it. I'll just throw out the knife. I just hate throwing away all that stuff. Now the mage robe I'm probably gonna put in the house just to keep unless we get another, because there's a bunch who can use it. Yeah, especially want to get a healer, definitely. So any one of these three could use that. And I'll probably store these away. There's nothing else I want to sell then. This is... yeah, this is for him. Yeah, that's it. We're good. We are good. Kind of curious. I don't know who sells these boots. Oh, mage can't even wear it. Never mind. Kind of wanted to buy boots for him, but he can't even wear leather boots. Never mind then. Alright, so 2 hours. Wow. Special 50th episode. Hope you guys enjoyed. Off screen, I'll be learning these spells and storing a few things in the house, and then we're gonna continue on. I'm not sure what we're gonna try to do next. To tell you the truth, try to find out how to get to Burnville, maybe? We're not good at swimming. I don't know where to get a raft. Maybe we just need to explore some more. Up north, where the actually, we might go to that swamp. We're waiting for the guy in the boathouse or the shipyard, whatever, to come back from wherever he is. There's a boy there now. He says he's waiting for his return, or he's been gone for a while, or something like that. So maybe something has to pass in the story for us to do that. But we'll go to the swamp next to get one of the ingredients for the fisherman's daughter. We got empty file from the Tower of the Alchemist just recently. And then a swamp east of the Tower of the Alchemist. We need to find a swamp lily. And then the spring of life on a high plateau in the mountains. So else we'll be doing that next, going for the swamp lily. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.